Hi all, today we can do the numericals based on wedge shape film. The main formula used in wedge shape film is fringe width beta is equal to lambda by 2 mu theta. Fringe width is the distance between two consecutive bright band or dark band. Lambda is the wavelength of light used. Mu is the refractive index of the film. Theta is the wedge angle. So we can see the first question. Fringes of equal thickness are observed in a thin glass wedge of refractive index 1.52. The fringe spacing is 1 millimeter and wavelength of light used is 5893 angstrom. Calculate angle of wedge. Fringes of equal thickness are observed in a thin glass wedge of refractive index 1.52. So mu equal to 1.52. The fringe spacing is 1 mm. That is, the fringe width beta is equal to 1 millimeter. That is 10 raised to minus 3 meter. And wavelength of light used is, that is, lambda is equal to 5893 angstrom. Calculate the angle of wedge. That is, we have to find out theta. So the general formula for the fringe width is beta is equal to lambda by 2 mu theta. So from this formula, theta is equal to lambda by 2 mu beta. So lambda is 5893 angstrom, that is 10 raised to minus 10 meter, divided by 2 into mu is 1.52, beta is 10 raised to minus 3 meter. So that is equal to 1.938 into 10 raised to minus 4. The SI unit of angle is radian. We can convert this radian into degree by multiplying with 180 by pi. So we will get 1.938 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 180 by pi, that is equal to 0.011 degree. Second question, interference fringes are observed on wedge shaped film of refractive index 1.4. The angle of wedge is 20 seconds of an arc and the distance between successive bright fringes is 0.25 cm. Calculate wavelength of light used. Interference fringes are observed on wedge-shaped film of refractive index 1.4. So, mu is equal to 1.4. The angle of wedge is 20 seconds. So, theta is equal to 20 seconds of an arc and the distance between successive bright fringes. The distance between successive bright fringes is known as the fringe width. That is equal to 0.25 centimeter. That is 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Calculate wavelength of light used. That is, we have to find out lambda. Here the angle is given in second. That second we have to convert into degree. So 1 degree means 60 minutes. Again 1 minute means 60 second. So here theta is equal to 20 second means, that is 20 by 60 minutes. Again to convert into degree, 20 by 60 into 60 degree. So to find out the wavelength of light used, we can use the general formula of fringe width, that is beta equal to lambda by 2 mu theta. Therefore, lambda is equal to 2 mu theta beta. So lambda is equal to 2 into mu is 1.4 into theta is 20 divided by 60 into 60 into beta is 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. So on calculating, we will get 3.888 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. See the next question. Two optically plane glass strips of length 10 cm are placed one over the other. A thin foil of thickness 0.01 mm is introduced between them at one end to form an air film. If the light used has wavelength 5900 angstrom, find separation between consecutive bright fringes. Two optically plane glass strips of length 10 cm are placed one over the other. A thin foil of thickness 0.01 mm is introduced between them at one end to form an air film. If the light used has wavelength 5900 angstrom, find separation between consecutive bright fringes. Separation between two consecutive bright fringes means we have to find out the fringe width beta. So here using glass strips of length 10 cm and air wedge is formed with the help of a foil of thickness 0.01 mm. So the interference fringes are produced and we want to find out the distance between two consecutive bright fringes. That is the fringe width beta. The expression for fringe width beta is lambda by 2 mu theta. Lambda is given. Here the wedge formed is because of air. So the refractive index mu is equal to 1. So only unknown value is angle of wedge theta. But we can find out the angle of wedge theta by taking the ratio of tan. That is, tan theta is equal to 0.01 mm, that is 10 raised to minus 3, divided by length 10 centimeter, that is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2. So that is equal to 10 raised to minus 4. If theta is very small, tan theta we can consider as theta. So theta is equal to 10 raised to minus 4. SI unit is radian. Here theta is small, therefore tan theta is considered as theta. Now we can substitute this data in this for general formula, that is beta is equal to lambda 5900 angstrom, that is into 10 raised to minus 10, divided by 2 into refractive index of air is 1 into theta is 10 raised to minus 4. So that is equal to 2950 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter, or 2.95 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter, or 2.95 millimeter. So the distance between two consecutive bright fringes is 2.95 millimeter. Next question. Two plain rectangular pieces of glass are in contact at one edge and are separated at the other end 10 centimeter away by a wire to form wedge shaped film. When the film was illuminated by light of wavelength 6000 angstrom, 10 fringes were observed per centimeter. Determine diameter of the wire. So two plain rectangular pieces of glasses are in contact at one edge and the other end, which is 10 centimeter away by a wire to form a wedge shaped film. When the film was illuminated by light of wavelength 6000 angstrom, 10 fringes were observed per centimeter. So determine diameter of the wire. Let D be the diameter of this wire. So we have to find out D. So the diameter of the wire we can find out using angle of wedge theta. Because this angle of wedge theta is equal to, that is approximately equal to tan theta, because theta is very small, tan theta equal to theta, that is equal to opposite side D divided by L. So we can find out this diameter of wire by the expression D equal to L theta. So here L is given, that is 10 centimeter, theta we don't know. So we have to find out the angle of wedge theta. So the angle of wedge theta we can find out using the fringe width expression. So what is the expression for fringe width? Fringe width beta is equal to lambda divided by 2 mu theta. So from this theta is equal to lambda by 2 mu beta. So lambda is 6000 angstrom, that is 6000 into 10 raised to minus 10, divided by 2 into, so here refractive index is not mentioned that any liquid, so we can consider it as air. So refractive index of air is 1 into beta. 10 fringes per centimeter. So what is will be the fringe width? In 1 centimeter is corresponding to 10 fringe. So 1 fringe distance will correspond to 1 by 10 centimeter. That is 0.1 centimeter will be beta. So beta is equal to 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. So beta equal to 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. So on calculating this will get 3 into 10 raised to minus 4. SI unit of angle is radian. So now we can find out the diameter of the wire, that is D is equal to L theta. So D is equal to L is 10 centimeter, that is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Theta is 3 into 10 raised to minus 4 radian, that is equal to 3 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. So the diameter of the wire here is 3 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Next question. In wedge shaped film interference pattern, distance between third and fifth dark band is 0.09 centimeter when the film is of air. When a liquid is introduced between the glass plates, distance between fourth and 12th bright bands becomes 0.24 centimeter. Determine refractive index of liquid. in this question, first the film is of air is considered. In the second case, the film of liquid is considered. So in the case of wedge shape air film, the distance between third and fifth dark band is 0.09 centimeter. So what will be the distance between third and fifth dark band? That means 2 beta. So that is in air, that is equal to 0.09 centimeter. Secondly, a liquid is introduced between the glass plate. So the distance between 4th and 12th dark band becomes 0.24 centimeter. So here the medium is liquid. The distance between 4th and 12th dark band means 12 minus 4, that is 8 beta. So what we have to find out? The refractive index of the liquid. Here the refractive index of the liquid we can determine using the fringe width expression. So the general expression for fringe width beta is equal to lambda divided by 2 mu theta. So in the first case, 2 beta equal to 0.09 centimeter, and that is in air. So in air, beta is equal to lambda divided by 2 mu air theta. And the second case, it is a liquid. So in liquid, beta is equal to lambda by 2 mu liquid theta. So here in the first case, 2 beta is equal to 0.09 centimeter. So beta is equal to 0.09 divided by 2 centimeter. So this is equation number 1. In the second case, that is in liquid, 8 beta equal to 0.24. So beta equal to 0.24 by 8 centimeter. Now we can divide these two equations. So equation 1 divided by equation 2 is equal to, here lambda by 2 theta, lambda by 2 theta will cancel, and this mu liquid will come in the numerator. So mu liquid divided by mu air is equal to 0.09 divided by 2, here 8 divided by 0.24. So refractive index of air is equal to 1. So on solving, we will get it as refractive index of liquid is equal to 1.5. Next question, a square cellophane film with a refractive index 1.5 has a wedge-shaped section so that its thickness at two opposite sides are T1 and T2, T2 greater than T1. If it is illuminated with a light of wavelength 6000 angstrom, the number of fringes appearing on film is 10. Calculate the differences T2 minus T1. A square cellophane film with a refractive index mu equal to 1.5 has a wedge-shaped section so that its thickness at two opposite sides are T1 and T2 with the T2 greater than T1. So that means we have a wedge shape, but at one side its thickness is not given as 0. There is a small thickness T1 there. At the other end the thickness is T2. That is one part of the wedge-shaped film is given. So, if it is illuminated with a light of wavelength 6000 angstrom, so lambda equal to 6000 angstrom, the number of fringes appear on this film section is 10. That is, if the length of this wedge is L, then in the L length, we have 10 fringes, that is L equal to 10 beta. So, calculate the difference T2 minus T1. So, to find out the T2 minus T1, we can form a triangle here. So, it is a part of a wedge, but this angle also will be angle of wedge theta. So, tan theta will be this opposite side, that is, this side will be T2 minus T1. Okay. So, this tan theta equal to T2 minus T1 divided by L. So, tan theta we can approximate to theta, because when theta is very small, tan theta can be considered as theta. So, that is equal to T2 minus T1 by L. What we want to find out? T2 minus T1. So, T2 minus T1 is equal to L theta. Now, we have to substitute for L and theta. So, theta we can find out from the expression fringe width. So, fringe width beta is equal to lambda divided by 2 mu theta. So, theta is equal to lambda divided by 2 mu beta. In this L theta, L equal to 10 beta and theta is equal to lambda by 2 mu beta. So, this beta and beta will cancel and we will get 5 lambda divided by mu. So 5 into lambda is 6000 angstrom divided by mu. Mu is 1.5. On calculating this, we will get 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter. So you try more questions. All the best.